on second down. Hillman again. And he's got some space here. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. That burst good for 20 and a first down.
They're trying to show it.
This is Hillman on first and 10. And he'll go down here at the 35-yard line. That one good for 10 yards. And that'll bring up
an end in the running game and say, okay, we've got to throw it in order to pick it up. Stayed with the run, was rewarded with a big-time pickup. Now they're in second and manageable.
Looking right sideline, but it's incomplete. They'll try to run for the first with Hillman. And he's going to be taken down right at the line. They'll be marked inches short. No gain on the play.
Tighter together. A little more shoulder to shoulder. Trying to wedge a hole in the middle. He didn't get it done on that play.
And he gets it to the 34. Good enough for the first. Just a 1 yard pickup on the play. And they're able to convert here on fourth and inches.
Hey, fourth and inches. Why let him die? And he just makes sure he secures the football and then plows forward to pick up the first down.
Fitzpatrick to throw it. That's complete over the middle to Anderson. And he's going to get this down near the 20-yard line. Version in 8 tries. Not good. This is 3rd and 11. Now Fitzpatrick. And he comes back with one complete. And he's brought down just outside of the 10 at the 11. They'll get 10 there, but it leaves him just shitsily to get to him and keep him short of the first. Beating the tough yards, they run him with their fullback. And he's able to pick up the first down before he's tackled right at the 10. They'll run here with Hillman. And a nice pick up there as he'll take it from the 10 down to the 5-yard line. They'll give to McFadden. And not a whole lot there. He does get anemic. A very anemic. 1 for 9 thus far. They're looking at a 3rd and goal here. Steps away to his left. He may try and run for this. He opted to go with a scramble. Gets 2 yards and now it's 4. More interesting here on 4th and goal. Fitzpatrick. And they're going to get to him. A sack. Sack back at the 9-yard line.
Just wound up going nowhere.
Well, you know how in baseball when the pitcher gets a base hit and he's on base, they bring his jacket out to him to keep him warm? A lot of times the punter goes to the sideline, puts on sweatpants or a wrap over.
Nowhere to go here. He lost the football. And they've got it very deep in enemy territory. It's inside the 5 at the 3-yard line, 1st and goal.
After that play, I think we know one quarterback will be extremely happy if his defense can hold the opposing team to a field goal here.
Set to take the field.
But you didn't hold us the whole time. We got down in position. We were able to be in position to score. Let's go on attack again. Continue to have that kind of confidence. Not worry about the run play that didn't allow him to get into the end zone.
This time they'll be trying to get it into the end zone. We'll see what they do. They come up at an offset eye. And they'll turn to the power game to try to get in. And he gets halfway there down to the 1-yard line. Their fullback try and push the pile. And he will fight his way into the end zone for a Cowboy touchdown. It's the fullback taking it in from a yard out. And the Cowboys use the short field to their advantage as they cash in for 6. Well, if at first you don't succeed, try again. They go to the big man, second time he gets it done.
Almost as if they were feeling like he was establishing a rhythm. Give it to him again and again.
Smoke some dank. Tell it all in
the
Old National got stanks. Everybody. Well, it's the M.I. Trigger letter. Ain't no one better. And when I'm on the microphone, you best to wear your sweater, cause I'm cooler than the pole. polar bear's toenails. Oh, hell, there he go again. Talking that shit. Bend corners like I was a curve. I struck a nerve. And now you about to see this other player serve. I heard it's not where you from, but where you pay rent. Then I heard it's not what you make, but how much you spend. You got me bent like elbows, amongst other things, but I'm not worried. Cause when we set up in the party, like I'm out, you scurry. So go get your fucking shine box and your sack of nickels. It tickles to see you try to be like Mr. Pickles. Daddy Fat Sacks, B-I-G-B-O-I is that same motherfucker that took them knuckles to your eye. And I try to warn you not to test, but you don't listen. Giving a shout out to my uncle Donnell, locked up in prison.
Now throw your hands in the air and wave them like you just don't care. And if you like fishing grits and all that pimp shit, everybody let me hear you say, oh yeah, girl. Now throw your hands in the air and wave them like you just don't care. And if you like fishing grits and all that pimp shit, everybody let me hear you say, oh yeah, girl.
Now, my oral administration be like clitoral stimulation to the female gender. Ain't nothing better, let me know when it's wet enough to enter. If not, I wait, because the future of the world depends on if or if not the child we raise gon' have that nigga syndrome. Or will it know to beat the arch regardless of its skin tone? Or will it feel that if we tune it, it just might get picked on? Or will it give a fuck about what others say and get gone? The alienators, cause we different, keep your hand to the sky. Like sounds of blackness when I practice what I preach and don't lie. I be the baker and the maker of the piece of my pie. Now break a breaker, tenfold, can I get some reply? Now everybody say,
hands in the air and wave them like you just don't care. And if you like fishing grits and all that pimp shit, everybody let me hear you say, oh yeah, girl. Now throw your hands in the air and wave them like you just don't care. And if you like fishing grits and all that pimp shit, everybody let me hear you say, oh yeah, girl.
Every day I sit while my nigga be in school, thinking about the second album at the dungeon, shooting cool like ES to the PA, cause we just to the beat in the zone. Honey, I'm home.